Hi, I'm David Olala, President and Chief Innovation Officer for SkyPoint Ventures. I'm on the road meeting with innovators and entrepreneurs to get a better understanding of what drives them to pursue an entrepreneurial lifestyle. We're swinging by the Calumet Coliseum, deep in the heart of Copper Country, in Michigan's Upper Peninsula. One of the oldest continuously operating skating rinks in North America. We're here to find Erik Kiilunen of Neuvokas, maker of the GatorBar, a truly disruptive technology taking on an old standard.
Hey, there he is.
Erik, how you doing?
Good. How about yourself, Dave?
Good. Real good. Hey, I want to learn about Neuvokas and GatorBar and what you're doing here in Calumet.
Awesome. Maybe we should take this to Cafe Rosetta?
Would love to.
Perfect. Let's do that. You're going to enjoy this elevator ride.
We're at the Calumet Coliseum, and I can't tell if we're in an elevator or a sauna. It's awful cozy in here. The elevator at the Calumet Coliseum is about the size of a large hockey bag. And if you're willing to get in this and take a ride to the top, you just might find yourself where you want to be. So Erik, here we are in Calumet. We're in an elevator. What's the elevator pitch?
We developed a process to manufacture FRP rebar that's an order of magnitude faster than our current competitors. And we're leveraging that advantage to capture a significant share of the global $140 billion rebar market.
And what does rebar do, in case people don't know?
Keeps concrete together.
Okay, so it's reinforcement
bar. Yeah, you're from Michigan?
I'm from Michigan.
You ever seen the bridges with the concrete falling off and you see the rusty rebar behind
it?
Yep. Ours doesn't rust.
So it's the scaling and the rust, and that's what causes the concrete to fall apart?
A good chunk of the time.
Okay.
It'd be technical going beyond that.
Sure. So you're telling me that you've got a global business located in Calumet, Michigan?
You got it. You can't really see it yet, but that is what we're doing.
How crazy does it sound to have a global company out of a very remote part of not only Michigan, but the world at that? What is that like?
Well, you told me you're an entrepreneur. So you look for things that aren't normal. You look for the anomalies. And one of the things we have in this area is we have a high degree of talent, intelligence. We've got a local university, Michigan Tech. In fact, my two key guys are both graduates of Michigan Tech. I took the fast track through Tech 4 weeks and out.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, we got a talent base up here. We got people that, you know, believe it or not, want to live up here.
Which actually, so in the UP, right, so we're in the copper country. You've got the iron ore range going through the Upper Peninsula.
Yeah.
There's a little bit of irony in the fact that you're taking a product that was done in steel.
I like your selection of words.
And now you're using some, you know, basalt fibers to put this together in a composite. Is there an opportunity of you know, reusing, upcycling what's been mined and is sitting in the UP in some of these products?
The short answer is yes. You're talking to a guy who doesn't know how to say no. If you give me a challenge, that's part of what drives me, is being told
That's the invitation, right?
That's the invitation, yeah. You're suckering me here.
And
The reality is it's using waste stream from an iron mine just simply wouldn't work with basalt fiber, but using a waste stream from an old copper mine could potentially work.
There's one trait that is identified with successful entrepreneurship. It's not the amount of money that you have. It's not the amount of education you have. It's grit is the word they used. Now, Finns have a much better word for grit, right? Sisu. So explain how sisu plays into your business world.
You might understand this, you might not, but you ever had the feeling that you're not employable?
I know I'm not employable.
Precisely. So what does that allow you to do?
Anything I want.
That's right. And it also allows everybody else to tell you what?
Anything they want.
Exactly.
But I don't have to listen.
Which is usually what?
Right.
Right. So fundamentally, I don't know, as far as grit goes, I guess I just, there's some things I don't like. I don't like to micromanage. I don't like to be micromanaged. I enjoy a lot of freedom. You know, I'm trying to give this to my people is, you know, hey, you want to come work, you're not going to be micromanaged, but that also means that you do have to get up in the morning and figure out what you want to do.
Yeah, you live and die by the sword.
Exactly.
And it's your sword and your sheath.
Yeah, so as far as grit goes, I don't know that I'm any different than most of the guys I hang with, but then I typically hang with people that do their own bit, you know, that are...
That make it happen.
Yeah.
What advice do you have for budding innovators and entrepreneurs who are thinking of reasons not to move forward? Because I have to believe that you never thought of a reason not to move forward. You've only thought of ways to move forward.
Don't.
That's fair. It's honest.
It's fair.
If you can't see $100 million behind it, probably don't. You know, a lifestyle business, wonderful, but that's not an entrepreneur.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so somebody that goes open a coffee shop, for lifestyle business, that's what they want to do.
That's a small business operator.
Yeah, Starbucks, different.
Yep, but franchise, yeah, or but you buy in, right?
Exactly, so a lot of small business, number one, I would just, probably wouldn't offend anybody. I'd probably just listen to them and find out where they're at, and if they're going after a small business, I'd just kind of give them whatever I can give them. Mm-hmm. But somebody that has a passion for it, there's few and far between is what I've found. And those people are hard to kill.
All right, Dave, I really appreciate you coming up to Calumet all the way to Northland to see us.
Love it.
Thank you so much.
Great to hear about GatorBar, and I wish you the best on the way to the top.
Thanks so much. Take care.